and I found that practicing to come out on tour with a little person in tow is very different to practicing to come out on tour before. You sort of get halfway through a song and think, God, I cannot sing this child another murder ballad. And so you just start flinging around on your ukulele and see what comes out. And that was one of the songs that turned out that I knew some of the chords for. And I thought I'd share it with you. I hope that you enjoyed it. Right then, I've gone completely off track. Has anyone got the time? No one.
I'm a seven.
Oh, thanks. Well, nobody's got time. In which case, we're going to do one more. Sorry, 9:50. All right, I've got time for a little bit more. So I'm going to do you a couple. I think that'll take us to about the time we're supposed to be at. I mentioned earlier that I wrote an EP for the Open University, which is a really random thing to have done, and it came to me, the universe handed it me, basically. I didn't go looking for it, but this fellow at the Open University, a guy called Joe Smith, was running a country, national project on the future of sustainability in our country. And one of his focuses was the Derwent Valley, which is where I'm from. And if you know your history, you'll know that the Derwent Valley is one of at least 10 places in the world that claims to be where the Industrial Revolution began. It definitely was. So anyway, I got sort of roped in as, oh, a folk singer from Derby, she's bound to know about the Industrial Revolution, and sort of got asked to be part of this thing. So anyway, it wasn't just creative people, it wasn't just me and Joe, it was policy makers, anthropologists, geologists, architects, chemists, you know, all sorts of people were kind of coming together to put together interesting papers on the subject. And anyway, they sort of realised that would be way too vast and dense and put on a library shelf somewhere for the majority of us, myself included, to ever read. So the main reason they invited creative people to be involved is because they wanted their work and their research to be turned into these like little palatable nuggets. And so there were musicians like myself, but there were also filmmakers and puppeteers and people that make theatre. It's the most exciting, interesting thing to be part of. Anyway, long story, a little bit longer. One of the things that transpired is that I got to sit in a room of young people from Sheffield University presenting their final designs for eco factories. And really interesting things, all sorts going on. But there was this young woman there, and in the centre of her fantastic factory, she had designed a clock that ran based not on time, but on the carbon output of the factory. So, you know, bad day would go whizzing around, good day, time would slow down, and a really, really great day, if the factory was functioning exactly as it should, time could even go backwards, you know, based on the carbon output that they were doing. And I thought that was a fabulous idea, but most exciting about it is that she'd taken an idea out of my head that I put in a drawer not 4 years previous to this moment. I don't know how she did it, people of the Isle of Wight, but I've written these lines like 4 years before this moment happened. The quickening clock beats out the time. The beat won't stop, won't fall in line. And just her describing this clock, you know, the two things that came together like a lightning crash. Like, oh my God! And anyway, I must have scared her, because when she finished and, you know, she'd had all the proper academic feedback, I was like, you there! Tell me everything! And what she told me really provided me with a song that I think sums up the overarching problem that we face together. Simply that business as usual with regards to energy is no longer an option. We've got to get inventive and excited about renewable options. So anyway, this is the quickening clock. Hang on, how does it go? Oh, there it is. Quickening clock beats out the time. The beat won't stop, won't fall in line. The ticking, talk and tolling chime.
final song.